Hi, I'm Canon Lauren Holder, one of the clergy at the Cathedral of St. Philip, and this is a midday meditation for June 18th, 2020. Blessed be God, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit, and blessed be God's kingdom now and forever. Amen. The Lord be with you. Let us pray. O God, you made us in your own image and redeemed us through Jesus, your Son. Look with compassion on the whole human family. Take away the arrogance and hatred which infects our hearts. Break down the walls that separate us. Unite us in bonds of love. And work through our struggle and confusion to accomplish your purposes on earth. That in your good time, all nations and races may serve you in harmony around your heavenly throne. Through Jesus Christ, our Lord. Amen. A reading from the Gospel of Matthew. Today's lectionary reading is from the 18th chapter, verses 10 through 20, but I've added 5 verses from the beginning of the chapter for context. At the time, the disciples came to Jesus and asked, "Who is the greatest in the kingdom of heaven?" He called a child, whom he put among them and said, "Truly, I tell you, unless you change and become like children, you will never enter the kingdom of heaven. Whoever becomes humble like this child is the greatest in the kingdom of heaven. Whoever welcomes one such child in my name welcomes me. Take care that you do not despise one of these little ones, for I tell you, in heaven, their angels continually see the face of my Father in heaven. What do you think? If a shepherd has 100 sheep and one of them has gone astray, does he not leave the 99 on the mountains and go in search of the one that went astray? And if he finds it, truly I tell you, he rejoices over it more than over the 99 that never went astray. So it is not the will of your Father in heaven that one of these little ones should be lost. If another member of the church sins against you, go and point out the fault when the two of you are alone. If the member listens to you, you have regained that one. But if you are not listened to, take one or two others with you, so that every word you may be confirmed by the evidence of the two or three witnesses. If the member refuses to listen to them, tell it to the church. And if the offender refuses to listen even to the church, let such a one be to you as a Gentile and a tax collector. Truly, I tell you, whatever you bind on earth will be bound in heaven, and whatever you loose on earth will be loosed in heaven. Again, truly I tell you, if two of you agree on earth about anything you ask, it will be done for you by my Father in heaven. For where two or three are gathered in my name, I am there among them." The word of the Lord. I noticed something about this reading that hadn't struck me before. In reading the last paragraph, "If another member of the church sins against you, go and point out the fault when the two of you are alone. If you are not listened to, take one or two others with you. And if the member refuses to listen to them, tell it to the church." I generally think this sounds a lot like finger wagging and public shaming. And taken out of context, that's precisely how it can be interpreted. But notice how Jesus sets this up. First, he tells his friends to be more like children, to humble themselves. I believe if we are to point out another person's sin, we must not do it from a space of self-righteousness, but from a place of humility. This is certainly true when looking over the liturgy of confession in our Book of Common Prayer. after a person is absolved of their sin, the priest says to that person, "Pray for me, a sinner." Humility changes how we treat ourselves and others in response to God's abundant love. Next, Jesus tells us of the parable of the lost sheep and the rejoicing in heaven and in the heart of God when one who is lost is restored to community. This is why, if a person wrongs you and does not listen to you, you must bring one or two others with you to speak to the person again. It's not about ganging up on the person or bullying them into repentance. It's about restoring them to community. It's about reminding the person that the community exists and is seeking them out like a lost sheep. This is a helpful reminder to me in this moment because I feel like there is a lot of finger wagging and public shaming going on. And I'm not talking about the painful public lament we see expressed in protests. Though some may disagree to me, that feels a lot more like the church showing up alongside the person who has been wronged in an effort to restore community. No, what I'm talking about is the one-upmanship on social media and in the news about how to respond to COVID right, and how to do church right, and how to be anti-racist right. I see a lot of armchair referees stuck in their homes, expressing a lot of opinions about what others should be doing. I fall into that same space myself sometimes, and it's not a place of humility. It is not useful to restoring community, and it's not something that brings the kingdom of God any closer. When I find myself slipping into that space of self-righteousness, I sing to myself one of those camp songs that never left me. Humble thyself in the sight of the Lord. And I try to express my grievances as a fellow sinner in need of redemption. Grateful for the community of the faithful who seeks to know and show the love of God throughout the world. I pray that we would be humble this week. I pray that our humility would bring true repentance and amendment of heart. Amen. And I invite your intercessions. What is it that you want to pray for today? I am praying today for all who have suffered racism, for all who protest and all who protect our civil liberties, and for all who influence our public life. I pray for our individual and collective sin and for the willingness to seek redemption. I pray for all who are sick and all who are dying and all who love them. I'm praying today especially for Aunt Sandy. I pray for all healthcare providers, first responders, and their families. I pray for all who are sheltering at home, all whose work prevents them from sheltering at home, and all who are trying to figure out how to re-enter life in this new normal. I pray for all who are feeling especially alone and for all who are craving their alone time. Let us pray the words our Savior taught us. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom and the power and the glory forever and ever. Amen. The peace of God, which passes all understanding, guard your hearts and your minds in the knowledge and love of God and of God's Son, Jesus Christ. And the blessing of God Almighty, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit be with you now and remain with you always. Amen.